Hi, welcome to my channel. It's been a while since I've done one of these, so I thought I'd do a video on Irish girl names inspired by places in Ireland. Some of these names are very common, you'd hear often, some of them are a bit more unique, but all of them are inspired by towns, rivers, islands, places in Ireland. If you like this kind of thing, please give this video a like, subscribe for more, and let's get started. First up is Clare, and this is a county in Ireland, County Clare. A lot of people might already know the name Clare. It's spelled C-L-A-R-E. The other way of spelling it, C-L-A-I-R-E, is actually the French version. So this is the Irish version without the I. And it's a pretty common, pretty popular name in Ireland. It's derived from the Irish word clor, which means board or plank. And it comes from back in the olden days, there was a clor used to cross the River Fergus. And that's where they named the county from, this board or plank or clor that was used as a bridge. And County Clare is absolutely beautiful. It's where the cliffs of Moher are and the Burren, and stunning place and beautiful name. Clare. Next up is Lee, and this is inspired by the River Lee. Lee isn't as common as Clare, but it's still a pretty well-known name in Ireland, and it's spelled L-E-E and very easy to pronounce, just Lee. I know a Lee, and I knew her growing up, so I always knew it as a girl's name, but Lee is actually also very popular as a boy's name. And the River Lee is in County Cork, and it is the 10th longest river in Ireland. Next up is Tara, and it's spelled T-A-R-A, and another easy one to pronounce, just Tara. And it's inspired from the Hill of Tara, or in Irish, Knock na Tearraigh. And by the way, disclaimer, Irish words are pronounced differently depending on where in Ireland you are. I'm in Leinster, so this is how I'm pronouncing it. I'm sure it would be pronounced differently in Ulster and Connacht and Munster. And so please don't judge the way I'm pronouncing it. This is just how I do it where I am. And the Hill of Tara is one of the most important archaeological and mythological sites in Ireland. It dates back 5,000 years, and it was a burial site, a ceremonial site, and where the inauguration and seats of all the High Kings of Ireland have been. And there are so many stories that I could tell you about the Hill of Tara, but I don't have time for it in this video. But basically, the Hill of Tara is very steeped in Irish history, so the name Tara has good, strong Irish roots. Next up is Kells. And this one might be more common as a last name or a nickname, but I love it as a first name. It's spelled K-E-L-L-S and pronounced Kells. And Kells is a place in County Meath. And one of the most famous things about Kells is that it's where the Book of Kells comes from. The Book of Kells is a very famous, very important book. It's actually from 800 AD. So I think it's literally one of the oldest books in the world. And it features the four Gospels of the New Testament. And it was written by monks in Scotland, but it was kept in an abbey in Kells for centuries, which is why it's called the Book of Kells. And at the moment it's kept in Trinity College in Dublin, and it's one of the most popular tourist attractions in Ireland. So another name very steeped in Irish history, and yeah, I love it, Kells. Next up is Valentia, and this is an island off the west coast of Ireland. I think it's one of the most westerly points of Ireland, and it's spelled V-A-L-E-N-T-I-A, and it's pronounced Va-Len-Cha, Valentia. And there's a common name, Valencia, that a lot of people would know. That's Spanish. They're spelled the same except for the C and T, but Valentia is the Irish version. The name Valentia comes from the Irish Cúin Vale Insha. Cúin means harbour, Vale means mouth, and Insha means island. So harbour mouth of the island. And over time, Cúin Vale Insha evolved into Valentia. So it's not that common a girl's name, at least not where I am. I don't know any Valentias, but I think it's such a beautiful name, Valentia. Next up is the county that Valentia lies off of, and that is Kerry. Kerry is a hugely popular, very common name in Ireland. It's spelled K-E-R-R-Y and pronounced Kerry, Kerry. If you think of typical Irish landscape, like the cliffs and the mountains and the beaches and the lakes, that's County Kerry. It is one of the most stunning places in Ireland. A lot of films were shot there, like Harry Potter and Star Wars. It's such a beautiful place and such a beautiful name, Kerry. Next up is Avoca. And this comes from a little village in County Wicklow. And I live very near Avoca, so I've only ever known it as a place name. But when I was researching the video, I found loads of people talking about it as a girl's name, and it is a beautiful girl's name, so I decided to include it, but it would be a lot more rare and unique than some of the other names. It's spelled A-V-O-C-A, and it's pronounced A-V-O-C-A. Avoca. It comes from the Irish word Avoca, which means little treasure. And the place of Avoca is really beautiful, really quaint little village. And fun fact, Chris Pontius from Jackass used to live in this little Irish village, Avoca. The next name is Shannon, another popular, very common name. It's spelled S-H-A-N-N-O-N and it's pronounced Sha-nun, Shannon. And this one is after the River Shannon, which is the longest river in Ireland. And there's also a town called Shannon, which is quite new. It was only built in the 1960s. And there's also Shannon Airport, which is the airport on the west coast of Ireland. And so it's associated with a few different things, but the most common would be the river, Shannon. Next up is Bree, and this is after a small village in County Wexford. It's spelled B-R-E-E, or if you want to go the Irish way of spelling it, that's B-R-I-Fada. A fada is an accent over a vowel, and it's both are pronounced the same way, just Bree. And this one isn't as common as Shannon, but not as rare as Avoca. Like, it is a known Irish girl's name, but not as popular as some of the other names. And Bree, the village, is a very small village. I think the last census, it had only 193 people that lived there, but it is a village that has a lot of history to it. There are a lot of stories about Bree, and a lot of people might know the name from Bree Van de Kamp from Desperate Housewives. The next name is Lara, and it's spelled L-A-R-A-G-H, and it's pronounced La-ra, Lara. And it's derived from the Irish word loirach, which means the ruin or site of a building or place. So there are actually a few places in Ireland called Lara. I'm in County Wicklow, so I know the Lara in County Wicklow, and it's a really beautiful place, very scenic. It's a big tourist destination because it's so stunning, and gorgeous place, gorgeous name, Lara. Next up is Aaron, and this one might be primarily known as a boy's name, but I know a girl with this name, so it can be for both, and I love it. It's spelled A-R-A-N, and it's pronounced A-run, Aaron. And this comes from the Aran Islands off the west coast of Ireland. And it's thought that the name Aaron comes from the Irish word A-rin, which means kidney-shaped. So apparently one of the islands is kind of kidney-shaped, so that's where the name comes from. And the people that live on the Aran Islands, they speak primarily Irish, so it's part of the Gaeltacht. So it's very very steeped in Irish culture and a lot of Irish history too, because there's hill forts and things on the islands. So another strong Irish name. It's more rare than the others, but I love it, Aran. Next up is Phoenix. Another name that can be used for both girls and boys, and I think everyone knows this name. It's spelled P-H-O-E-N-I-X and pronounced Phoenix, Phoenix. And this one comes from Phoenix Park in Dublin. And Phoenix Park is absolutely huge. I think it's actually the biggest city park in all of Europe. It's where Dublin Zoo is, it's where the Irish president lives, there's lots of deer, it's just an amazing place. And the name Phoenix comes from the Irish words Finn Ishka, named after a river that runs underneath the park. Finn Ishka means clear water. Over time, Finn Ishka became Phoenix. And again, not a very common one, but a great name, Phoenix. Next up is Kira. One of the most common Irish names is Kira, spelled C-I-A-R-A. But if you wanted a different take on it, you could spell it after the Kira Islands. It's spelled K-E-E-R-A-G-H and pronounced the same way, Kira. Again, this can be pronounced differently all around Ireland, and they could say Kirach, Kirach, Kire, Kira. I researched this and there was just so many differing opinions about exactly how it's supposed to be pronounced, but I'm gonna go with the Kira crowd. So some people are saying Kira, I'm going with them. That's how I would read it. And Kira Islands are off the coast of Wexford, and the name is derived from Sheep Islands. And nobody lives on the Kira Islands, but there is the ruin of an old house that was built for refuge for shipwrecked sailors, of which there were a lot of. And while Kira is a hugely popular name in Ireland, This spelling is a little bit more rare, so I really like that it makes it a little bit more unique. Kira. The next name is Annalee. This isn't really a typical Irish girl's name, but it's very beautiful, Annalee. It comes from the river Annalee. It's a river in County Cavan, and it's named after the place that the river flows through, also called Annalee. But the difference is the river is spelled A-N-N-A-L-E-E, whereas the place is spelled A-N-N-A-G-H-L-E-E. So they just dropped the G-H for the river. And the meaning, it comes from the Irish words Anach Lay, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, which means, Anach means swamp or marsh, and Lay means calf. So it means swamp or marsh of the calf, which isn't the prettiest meaning for a name, but it's still a very pretty sounding name and a very nice river, Annalee. Next up is Sheelan, and this comes from Loch Sheelan, which is a lake between Cavan, Meath, and Westmeath. Sheelan means fairy pool. She means fairy, Lynn means pool. So a lot nicer meaning than Marsh of the Calf. The legend that this name comes from is that there was a fairy well that the fairies used to use, and then locals from the nearby village started using it too. But one day a local forgot to put the lid back on and it overflowed, and it became the Lake of the Fairy Pool, or Loch Sheelan. And Sheelan, as a girl's name in Ireland, is not extremely common, not extremely popular, but still a pretty known name, Sheelan. The next name is Kilishandra, and this is a place in County Cavan. A lot of these names are coming from County Cavan, and it's spelled K-I-L-L-A-S-H-A-N-D-R-A, Kilishandra. I'll put it here. I hope I got all the letters right, but and it's pronounced Kil-a-Shandra. And this one isn't a very common name in Ireland, but when I was researching the video, I found it's quite common outside of Ireland, especially in the US. It comes from the Irish Kilnashan Raha, which means church of the old fort, or church of the old ring fort. Kil means church, Na means of the, Shan means old, and Raha means fort or ring fort. So over time, Kilnashan Raha became Kilishandra. The next name is Clodagh, and this is a very popular name in Ireland today. It's spelled C-L-O-D-A-G-H, and it's pronounced Clodagh, Clodagh. And this is a river in County Waterford. And a fun fact about this name, in 1879, the Marquis of Waterford, his estate was where the river Clodagh ran through. So he decided to name his daughter Clodagh after the river Clodagh. And then she had a daughter and named her daughter Clodagh. And she said she always wanted the two of them to be the only Clodaghs. What a unique name. And that didn't last, because now there are a ton of Clodaghs all over Ireland. A very popular name, Clodagh. Next up is Quinn, and this one is a little bit more unique. It's known as a last name, but not that common as a first name. It's after a little village in County Clare. It's spelled Q-U-I-N and pronounced just Quinn. In Irish, it's Quinche or Quinche, again, depending on where in Ireland you are. And it means arbutus, which I guess is some kind of tree or plant. I don't know if I'm even pronouncing that right, and that's an English word. I don't know my trees or plants that well. So arbutus, I guess there was an arbutus grove where the land is now, so that's where it comes from, Quinn. Okay, I saved the best for last. All of these names are inspired by places in Ireland, and this last one is inspired by Ireland itself. It is Erin. It is spelled E-R-I-N and pronounced E-R-I-N. Erin. It is derived from the Irish word Era, which means Ireland, and Era is derived from Eru, who was a goddess who was the protector of Ireland. So Erin has strong roots in Irish history. It's a great Irish name and pretty common, pretty known in Ireland today. And that is my list of girl names inspired by places in Ireland. I'm going to do the boy version soon, so make sure to hit that notification bell if you don't want to miss it. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to see more, please subscribe, and thanks for watching. Bye.